Channel. I hope you're all doing well. Today's video is going to be another fall theme video because fall is upon us and that's what we're doing. I'm excited. I dressed for the occasion. It should be a good time. If you're new to my channel, definitely hit that subscribe button because this month I'm giving away an Urban Decay Naked Smoky palette to one lucky subscriber, and all you have to do is be subscribed, so that's the only rule. You can follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Snapchat, all those other things for extra entries, but the only rule is you need to be a subscriber. I'm also really excited to be working with Pocka Pets on this video, and you guys know that I only promote things that I genuinely love, and I've worked with Pocka Pets in the past, so it's no surprise. I love this app so much. I had a Tamagotchi as a kid. I don't know if you guys did too, but it was so much fun to raise an egg and like take care of it and kind of have like a pet to your own that's digital. This is basically the same thing, but on your phone. So it's very convenient. And it kind of also reminds me of the game Animal Crossing. If you guys have played that, I also really like this game. But the whole idea of Pocka Pets is you get an egg, you get to raise it. It has different levels, or like it evolves basically. There's over 70 different pets that you can end up with. So there's bound to be some new ones, and it's just so much fun because you get to go to the shop and buy food and different things like that. One of my favorite things though is the fact that you can decorate its room, and so you have to go to the store and pick out some furniture, purchase it, and then you can decorate, and the store refreshes like every hour, so there's always new cute stuff. And I just really like that part of the app because I like interior decorating, so I love doing that. And there's just so much to do on this app. It's honestly so much fun, especially if you guys have like a long commute to school or you're like sitting on a bus for a bunch of hours. This is a really fun game to kind of fill the time. Another really cool thing you can do in the app is take your Pocka Pet into town to meet and mingle with other different Pocka Pets in the Pocka world. And you can also do quests to earn more points. You're basically just doing like scavenger hunts and different things, but there's so many that you can do that you can earn a ton of points to then buy a ton of furniture and cute things like that. And I'm not gonna lie, it was a pretty proud moment when one of my Pocka Pets evolved old enough to actually leave the home and go live out his dreams. I think he became like a fashionista or something. It was amazing. I was very proud. But yeah, if you guys like games like that, I highly recommend you guys check out Pocka Pets. I love it. And I just, yeah, I can't say enough good things about it because I genuinely think it's so much fun. And if you guys want to check it out, I will have the link down below. And yeah, let's go ahead and jump into the DIY fall projects, all that jazz. Here we go. For the first DIY decor piece, you are going to need some twine, some mini clothespins, and some fake leaves. All you're going to do is take your mini clothespins and paint them whatever color you like. Obviously, I did mine copper because duh, but you can do gold or any other metallic I think would look really gorgeous on this, and you can paint it with regular paint or spray paint, whatever you have lying around. Once the clothespins are dry, go ahead and gather a few leaves. I did a bunch of them, so I took different colors from the package that I had. I had some metallic, some red, some yellow, and I just kind of bunched them together, took the clothespin, and then clipped them onto the string. This is probably the easiest DIY you've ever seen in your entire life, but it looks super duper cute. I put mine above my computer desk. If you guys have seen my desk before, I used to have a popsicle garland, so this kind of replaced it. It definitely gives my desk the perfect fall vibe, and it's also optional to add Polaroid pictures to this string as well. For the next DIY decor piece, I got absolutely all the things I needed for this at the dollar store, which was amazing, and I've been wanting to make one of these for my house for a really long time, so I figured I'd include it in this video. So you're gonna start off by gluing a piece of the ribbon down. You can totally put the leaves on first and then the ribbon, or the ribbon then the leaves. You know, it's totally up to you and how you want to do this. And then I just wrapped the ribbon around the twine thing and kept gluing as I go so it would stay in place. I also personally love this burgundy rich cranberry color for this fall. I think it is so gorgeous. I like wearing it in my makeup and having it as room decor. And then after that, once that's all glued down, you can go ahead and take your leaf vine type thing. And I used two of these. It's very difficult to show this on camera, but I basically just wrapped that around and played with it until I liked how it turned out. And then I also glued a ribbon bow onto the top, and that pretty well completes this wreath. I think this is so fall and so cute. And again, really inexpensive, but adds so much to your room. And the final
final DIY decor piece is perfect for those of you that love color but still want to have a little bit of a fall vibe. And I actually got this idea from Pinterest, this little picture. I think it was so cute. And if you're not following me on Pinterest, I will have mine linked down below because I am obsessed with Pinterest. So I started off with these styrofoam pumpkins that I got at the dollar store, and I painted them three different colors. As you can see, I did pink, purple, and blue, and I did two coats of paint on each because it did take a while to get them opaque. And then I'm just taking this Sharpie paint pen. It's an oil-based pen, and I wanted to make a saying on each of the pumpkins. So I really just took my time carving out the letters and then filling them in. And a tip for this is if you are using a Sharpie-like pen, take breaks and store it upside down so the ink does come out pretty clearly and opaque. As you guys can see, I did each word on each of the pumpkins just because these pumpkins in particular were kind of small. But if you are using regular pumpkins, you can go ahead and do like a full saying, as you saw in the picture, on a single pumpkin. I think that'd be really cute, especially if you are a little bit more girly and you want to have something outside for a decor piece for Halloween. I think that's really, really fun. If any of you guys recreate this DIY or any of the other ones in this video, definitely send me pictures on Twitter and Instagram because I would love to repost them. You guys are so creative, and I'm really curious to see what funny sayings you can put on these pumpkins because I think it's hilarious. And that completes the last DIY.
Let me know in a comment down below what your favorite part of this video was, and if you liked it, give it a thumbs up so more people can find this video and my channel. And if you're new, don't forget to subscribe before you leave so you don't lose me in this craziness that is YouTube, because that would be really tragic. And then you can also win the Urban Decay Naked Smoky Palette, and that would be a bomb too. And yeah, I will have Paka Pets linked down below if you want to go check it out, which you should because it's really fun. And I will see you lovely people in my next video. Have a great day. Bye.